Europe will not be blackmailed by Turkey over the refugee issue.
People are not just means to reach a goal.
Biz zaten 40 milyar doları aşkın harcamayı yaptık. Hani adil yük ve sorumluluk paylaşımı?
Tear gas, beatings, shootings, being stripped down to their underwear. Rather than protection and safety, refugees at the Greek-Turkish border are met with violence and intimidation.
With thousands of refugees amassing along the Greek and Bulgarian borders, police on the European side are being told to hold the line.
On February 28th, Turkey announced that it opened its borders to give refugees free passage to Europe. Tens of thousands of refugees and migrants have since tried to cross into Europe. However, on the Greek and Bulgarian side, the border remains closed, leaving thousands of migrants stuck in a no man's land between Europe and Turkey.
They came in the firm belief that this border would be open, but then they realized that's not true.
But Turkey has said the border will remain open until the EU takes more responsibility over the conflict in Syria and the refugees from Syria.
Adil yük ve sorumluluk paylaşımı beklentilerimiz ise ne yazık ki cevapsız kaldı.
So what is the situation right now at the border? And are the refugees and migrants still stuck? What has Europe done? Why is there so much disinformation? And why can no one agree on the number of refugees that have tried to cross? Now, since Turkey announced the free passage, Europe has sent a clear message that the border will remain closed.
And we have indeed seen groups of migrants who say they've just been sent back across the river.
In Greece, which is the first point of entry for a lot of migrants to Europe, armed and security forces have pushed back this new influx of migrants.
And some of them say they've been stripped of their clothes and shoes. We've seen evidence to corroborate that. We've seen people barefoot, wrapped in blankets.
There have been reports of violence on both sides of the border. For example, the Greek police reportedly has used tear gas to expel people from the border area. Now, some videos and photos on social media show that people have been stripped down to their underwear, their phones and money taken away as they were sent back to the Turkish side.
We've also talked to migrants here who say they made it to Greece, were then detained by Greek border guards, beaten up, their phones were being taken from them, their money was being taken from them. They showed us the bruises they had from these beatings, and then they were sent back to Turkey, they told us.
Now, nearly 2 weeks later, Turkey also seems reluctant to take migrants stuck at the border back. Allegedly, Turkish authorities are even facilitating the movement of migrants towards the border, well aware of the kind of violence and intimidation they're facing from the European side.
So it appears Turkish authorities are somehow facilitating people's move and directing what's going on here at the border.
So Turkey has said that over 140,000 migrants have tried to cross to Europe, but the European side says this is only around 40,000. Why do you think there is such a discrepancy in numbers? Let us know in the comments below.
People have camped here, stayed day and night, outside in the open, in the cold. Border guards have used tear gas again against refugees to keep them out.
So while the situation at the Greek-Turkish border is escalating, many turn their eyes to Europe.
Europe has not been up to the task of dealing with the migration crisis.
What has the EU done? Well, honestly, not that much. In the wake of Brexit, Europe is unlikely to welcome any newcomers that would further polarize the union.
But what is clear is that all foreign ministers made clear here there will be no blackmail, there will be no using of refugees as bargaining chips in order to force Europe to spend more money.
The president of the European Commission, Ursula von der Leyen, visited the Greek side of the border. In a press conference after, she called Greece the shield of Europe and vowed 700 million euros to help with border management.
I thank Greece for being our European aspida in these times. Turkey is not an enemy, and people are not just means to reach a goal.
She also said that Europe would send military personnel through its border agency Frontex. Turkey, too, is employing 1,000 special forces to prevent people from returning to Turkey.
Turkey deployed special forces to block the return of any migrants who've illegally entered the EU.
Now, through this militarized response, Europe, Turkey, Greece seem to care more about national security and reinforce the idea that migrants and refugees are a threat we need to save ourselves from.
For the Greek government, this is a threat for the national security. This is an attempt to violate the borders of Greece and the borders of the European Union.
The Greek government announced that it would suspend any asylum applications for a month. This is in violation of international law and breaches the right to asylum. The UNHCR, the UN's refugee agency, has been quite silent. For example, it has not called out Greece for suspending asylum applications.
EU leaders today have let Greece off the hook for closing its borders and off the hook for shutting down the right to asylum for people in need. The border is not a human rights free zone.
While governments are clearly breaching the international agreements they've signed, the world's arguably biggest human human rights organization does little to nothing to make sure they uphold them. Now, surely there's been a lot of talks behind the scenes, but by choosing quiet diplomacy over publicly addressing the issue, is the UN inadvertently sending a message to other governments that it's okay to close borders as they wish? Now, 2 weeks later, and with thousands still stuck at the border, will we see a refugee camp between two countries, or will Turkey be taking back these migrants? What do you think? Let us know in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe.